Hey guys, I welcome you all again. So in the first part of this video, I have discussed the mechanism of market of rule, right? Means why the negative part of the addendum will get attached to the dead carbon atom of the double bond, which has lesser number of atoms, right? So we have discussed this whole thing in the first video. Means if you take an unsymmetrical alkene, that is propene, right beta? So this addendum, that is your Br minus, will attach to that carbon atom which has lesser number of hydrogen atoms, right? So by doing so, beta, two bromopropane will be formed, right? And one bromopropane as minor and two bromopropane as major, right? So we have already seen the mechanism, this reaction mechanism, right, of Markov Minkoff rule. So now in this video, we'll see what is anti-Markovnikov rule. Anti-Markovnikov rule, or you can say addition, right? Its other name, beta, also you can say peroxide effect. It's also called peroxide effect, and you can also say Kharash effect. Right, beta? This was the name of the scientist, M.S. Kharash. Okay. So, see in this peroxide effect or anti-Markovnikov addition, what happens? Right, beta? So, see in the presence of beta peroxide, right? In the presence of peroxide, the addition of halogen acid, that is HX, right, to an unsymmetrical alkene, beta, takes place contrary to beta Markovnikov rule. Okay, means in the presence of peroxide, the same reaction, beta, in the presence of Markovnikov, right, in the presence of peroxide, the same reaction will take place, but the thing is, the products are opposite to the Markov. Okay, see, and beta, this effect, you can say, you can also write this peroxide effect is observed only with hydrogen bromide, right, that is HBr. So beta, this peroxide effect is, you can say, only observed with HBr, right, not with any other, it's like HF, HCl and HR. Okay, why do so, beta? We'll discuss after a few minutes. Okay, so see, now just come on to the mechanism, right, of anti-Markovnikov. Okay, beta, now see, now again I'm taking an example, right, beta, an unsymmetrical alkene, again I'm taking propene. Okay, this is propene, and again this is unsymmetrical alkene, right, means if you cut this molecule, beta, into two half, so it will not generate two equal parts, right, or you can say it contains two different groups on the both side of the carbon-carbon double bond, right? Means on the left hand side, you can see double bond, there are two hydrogen, and the right hand, right hand side, there are two hydrogen, on the left hand side, there is only one methyl and one hydrogen. Okay, see. So now, beta, I just write this equation, right, with HBr. Now the condition is in the presence of peroxide. So product again will form 2-bromopropane. Plus 1-bromopropane, right? This is 2-bromo. And this is 1-bromo. Two bromopropane and 1-bromo. So beta, in the case of, you can say, in the presence of peroxide, it was observed that beta means 1-bromopropane, right, was formed as major product, right, whereas this 2-bromopropane beta was observed as minor. This is just reverse now, you can say, of the Markovnikov addition, right. So in this case, we can take beta this peroxide as hydrogen peroxide, H2O2, or you can also take benzoyl peroxide. Okay, so we'll see the mechanism. Beta, first of all, see this beta anti-Markovnikov addition or Kharash effect beta proceeds via free radical mechanism. Okay, means anti-Markovnikov products, you can say in this case, on via beta free radical mechanism. Okay, see what is the first step. So first step beta is a homolytic cleavage, right? You can say homolysis. So if I take beta benzoyl peroxide, C6, this is the formula of H5, molecular formula, COOCOC6H5, right? This is the molecular formula of benzoyl peroxide. Okay, so what happened beta? See in this case, if I just representing beta, this bond that is present in between two oxygen atoms, right? It's a covalent bond. So beta, in this case now, homolysis take place, right? Means a homolytic cleavage will take place here. So one electron is come with the one oxygen and another with another oxygen. Okay, and homolytic will take place between these two oxygen atoms. So what will be the product? This symmetrical molecule beta, this C6H5COO with one unpaired electron will form, right? So I'm just writing 2C6H5CO because the same molecule will form. Okay, means this group beta containing only one unpaired electron will form. Okay, now what happened beta? Again, a homolytic cleavage will occur here. So I can also write undergo homolysis, right? Will undergo homolysis beta again. So see again in this case, there are two electrons between these two carbon atoms, right? This is a covalent bond, right beta? That is between C6H5 benzene and CO, right? So again beta, here a homolytic cleavage will take place. Means this electron beta will come with this carbon atom of this benzene ring, and this electron will come with this carbon. Okay, so it will break in this manner. It will form beta C6H5 radical, and there will be two radical, and this is called beta phenyl radical, phenyl free radical, because it is formed on the benzene ring. Okay, this is phenyl free radical. Now just see carefully here what happened to the other molecule. See, if I just break this bond now beta, so it will form CO, break into COO, and I can just write this electron at the bottom, right? And beta, one electron beta has come again on the carbon atom. So beta, this electron which is present on carbon and the another electron which is present on the oxygen, you can say just self combine, right? Because you can see these are the unpaired electrons, they get a cell combined and it will form a new bond, right? So this complete molecule beta will become CO2, that is your carbon dioxide. Okay, means the one electron that is present of oxygen just combine with the another unpaired electron that is present on the carbon after homolytic cleavage. Okay, so they will just combine. So I can just write beta will form CO2. Okay, in this, so this will again two CO2 molecule will form. Got it? Right. So see, now this is the first step. Now what will happen? Second phase, second step. This phenyl radical beta C6H5 radical. I'm just writing only one molecule, right? Reacts with halogen acid, that is hydrogen bromide, right? Again, beta here, a homolytic cleavage will take place. You can also write homolysis. Right? See, this is the electron, this is another electron. Right? So this electron come on hydrogen, this electron on bromine. So now beta, this hydrogen will combine with this C6H5. Okay, so both the unpaired electrons just form a new bond and it will convert into benzene ring, that is C6H5 to benzene, along with the formation of beta BR radical. This is our BR radical. Okay, so this is the second step. Fine. Now see what happened beta. Third step. This is the important. Right? See, this case writing the reaction of beta this BR with our alkene, that is unsymmetrical. So I am taking another very simple example of unsymmetrical alkene, that is propene. Okay, so now beta this bromine radical will react with this propene, right? So writing this bromine react radical, right? So beta, now there are two carbon atoms again. This is one and this is two, right? So I'm again beta just writing two way. If bromine is attached to the carbon one, right? And the second case, it will attach to the carbon two. Okay? So see, if beta this BR radical, so I'm just writing here, attached with this second you can say carbon, right? So what will happen? See, again beta, here a homolytic cleavage, you can also understand this by writing in this manner, CH double bond CH2. So it can also undergo beta homolytic cleavage in this way, right? So in this way beta, it will convert into CH3, CH radical, CH2, CH radical. Okay, so we can say both the carbon atoms has one unpaired electron, right? So if it will attach to beta second carbon atom, right, means this carbon atom, so it will convert into CH3 CH, the bond will break between these two carbon atom, right, and it will convert into this radical. This will remain as such, this electron will remain as such, right, and this bromine will attach with the second, with this first carbon atom, that is this one, right? So this will convert into CH2 BR beta, है ना? If there are two carbon, right, having one unpaired electron, so this bromine in this case beta will attach to the first carbon atom, means this one. So it will convert into this CH3 CH radical CH2 BR, right? And in the second case beta, if it will attach to the first carbon atom, right? Sorry, just write, was it? Just make it one. This is two. Okay. So in this case it is one beta and in this case it is carbon two. So if this BR beta attached to second carbon atom, right, and then what will be the product? CH3, right? This will attach with this carbon, so CH and the BR, right, and this will convert into CH2 radical. So these two free radicals beta will form if this BR radical will combine with one. So this product, if this combined with carbon second, so this one, right? So we can again beta see this is a free radical, and we know beta this free radical is attached with two another carbon atom, that is this one, and this one. So this will considered as secondary free radical, right? And this carbon containing unpaired electron is attached to another carbon atom. So this will be secondary free radical. And in this case, beta, see, this carbon is attached only with one carbon atom, right? Means directly attached with only one carbon atom. So this will, we can say, this will be primary free radical. And we know, beta, the free radicals are electron deficiencies, right? Means they need more electron density, right? So beta, we also know the stability order of free radicals. So we know, beta, tertiary free radicals are more stable as compared to the secondary, and secondary are more stable as compared to the primary. So beta, according to the stability order, I can write this secondary free radical will be more stable and this will be less stable. And why it is less stable and it is more stable, beta? See, we can understand this, beta. This free radical is electron deficient species, right? So there are, beta, two, you can say, methyl group, that is one CH3 and then CH2, right? So there will be plus I effect, right? And if there are two carbon atom, beta, so we can say there will be two plus I effect, right? And in this case, see, there is only one carbon atom that is attached with this carbon atom. So beta, this whole group will act as one group, right? So in this case, beta, I can write again also a plus I effect, right? But only one plus I effect of this proper group, CH3, CHBr, this group, right? And in this case, there are two carbon atom, right? So in this case, you can say there are two, right? But this complete group will act as an alkyl group, okay? So in this case, there is only plus one, sorry, one plus I effect, and in this case, there are two plus I effect, right? So therefore, beta, secondary free radicals are more stable as compared to the primary, okay? Now, so beta, we can say secondary free radical being more stable forms predominantly because secondary radicals are, beta, more stable, so it will be formed predominantly, right? So this was the, you can say, in this case, this is the third step, right? Now see, so this will be our secondary radical. Now what will happen, beta, in the fourth step? So I'm just writing again, secondary radical, CH radical, this is CH2Br, right? This one, CH3, CH radical, CH2Br. I've just written this molecule. Okay. Now see, beta, this molecule, free radical, will react with another molecule of HBr. Okay. Again, a homolysis will take place. Politic cleavage, right? So again, I can also represent this electron will combine with this radical, right? So form this way. In these two electrons. Okay. So it will convert into CH3. This will become CH, will become, beta, radical, CH2Br, right? So why? Because this is, you can say, formed predominantly right, secondary radical. Right, beta? So that's why our this one bromo propane will be formed as major product, right? This will be formed as major product. Why, beta? Because in this reaction, right, the secondary free radical, that is intermediate, is formed as major product, major intermediate, right, predominantly as compared to the primary. So in this case, beta, this free radical, beta, will again react with another HBr. It will form an alkyl halide, that is bromopropane, along with pr radical. So this will be major product, right? And the another primary radical will also here, right? This will be for this molecule CHBr. So this molecule beta will also react with the another HBr molecule. Right, again homolysis, I'm just writing directly now, right? So what will be the product? CH3CH is with Br, right? And this CH2 radical will become beta CH3 plus Br radical, right? So in this way you can also write this bond will break this one. Okay, so this is our 2-bromo propane, right? So interesting, starting for clearly this one. Okay, so in this way beta 2-bromo propane will be our minor. Why? Because this is from formed from beta primary free radical, which is less stable, so it will be forming lesser amount, right? Okay, so this is all beta our anti Markovnikov rule, right? And this is the mechanism. So initially beta, in the first step homolysis will take place, right? Benzoyl peroxide will dissociate into two you can say radical, right? Again homolysis will take place, it will produce again beta phenyl radical and carbon dioxide molecule. Then this phenyl radical beta will come react with HBr, so again benzene will form along with the formation of Br radical. Now finally this Br radical beta will react with our alkene, so there will be again two possibility, it will get attached to the carbon 1 or 2. So if it will get attached to carbon 1 beta, right, so it will form beta secondary free radical, and if it will attach to the secondary, so it will form primary radical. And we know secondary radicals are more stable as compared to the primary according to their reactivity order, right? So we can say secondary free radical being more stable form predominant, right? So then finally secondary free radical beta attack with another molecule of HBr, right? And it will convert into bromopropane with Br radical. This is finally our 1-bromopropane formed as major product and 2-bromopropane as minor. Okay, so if I just conclude beta the whole reaction here. See, I'm just writing few examples. CH3, CH, CH2, right? Then simply write HBr, HCl, HBr in the presence of peroxide. So what will be the product? See beta. In this case HBr, so simple Markovnikov addition reaction will take place, right? So CH3CHBr means the addendum will attach to that carbon atom which has less number of hydrogen, CH3, right? So this will be 2-bromopropane will be major product and this will be minor product. So just write only major product. Okay, so this is our Markovnikov, you can say, product, right, which is major. In this case second again Markovnikov reaction will take place, so CH Cl CH, so again Markovnikov product will form beta, right? In the second case, see, it is written as in the presence of peroxide, so in this case anti Markovnikov product will form, and what will be your major product? 1-bromo CH2 Br. So in this case this will be anti Markovnikov and this will be the major product 1-bromopropane. Okay, so this is all about Markovnikov and anti Markovnikov. Now see, the question is beta, why Kharash effect, or you can say peroxide effect. is observed only with HBr, right? Means why peroxide effect beta is only observed with HBr, not with HI or HCl or HF. So see, the answer is beta. The HCl bond, right beta, being more stronger than HBr bond, right? Means HCl bond is more stronger as compared to the HBr. Is not cleaved by the free radical, right beta? Means HCl bond is more stronger as compared to the HBr, so it will not break beta. You can say cleaved by free radical, right? But whereas HI is weaker, right? HI bond is weaker, so we can say iodine radical combine to form iodine molecule. Right? Instead of attached to the carbon-carbon double bond. Okay, beta. So see, HCl bond is stronger as compared to the HBr, so it will not cleave easily, right? When free radical attached to this group, right? So it will not break. And whereas in case of HI beta, it is weaker, so it will dissociate into simply HI. And HI radical beta, I radical will combine together and it will convert into I2 molecule. Okay, will not attach to the carbon-carbon double. Means in this tab you can say, this is test tab. When beta here, iodine radical will form now. So they will just get self combined and will not, you can say, attach with this alkene, right? And whereas in case of HCl, the bond will not break because it is more stronger as compared to the HBr. Okay, so this is the reason beta. That's why Markovnikov rule is only observed with only HBr, right? And again, with also not observed with beta HF. Again, this is due to their strong, you can say, bond dissociation enthalpy. Means more strong bond dissociation enthalpy, right? Means HF bond is also strong. So because it's, you can say, high bond dissociation energy or enthalpy. Okay. So again, when iodine radical will form now, they will get just self combined and converge to I2 molecule, not attack with alkene. Okay, and HCl bond will not break. So we can say it will not break into H plus. Sorry, so you can't write. Simply you can represent this one in this way. This bond will not break. Okay, so this is the reason. Right? Now you can also understand beta this concept. Actually, this reason beta actually is true, but it is written in NCERT, right? But you can also understand this one by another way. See, I'm just explaining you. If I just write X, this X is presenting in halogen acid HX. Okay, this halogen acid beta, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine, right? Means this X, maybe you are fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine in this halogen halide HX, right? Now I'm just writing the data of delta S, that is change in enthalpy. Okay, एंड इधर इट इस वैल्यू में भी नेगेटिव बेटा और इधर में भी पॉजिटिव. ओके सी नाउ ऑल्सो आई एम जस्ट राइटिंग द फर्स्ट केस राइट द रिएक्शन. सी दिस इज एक्स रेडिकल दिस वे इट विल रिएक्ट विद एल्कीन सी एच टू सी एच सी एच थ्री राइट बेटा. सो इट विल कन्वर्ट इन टू एक्स सी एच टू सी एच रेडिकल एंड सी एच थ्री राइट. दिस विल कन्वर्ट इन टू दिस. सो वी कैन जस्ट आई जस्ट रिप्रेजेंट दिस वन. दिस इज अ फर्स्ट रिएक्शन. स्टार्टिंग सेकेंड रिएक्शन. सी दिस ग्रुप बेटा एक्स सी एस थ्री राइट. दिस रेडिकल नाउ अगेन अटैक विद अनदर एच एक्स मॉलिक्यूल राइट. सो अगेन इट विल कन्वर्ट इन टू इन दिस वे एक्स सी एस टू सी एस टू सी एस थ्री एक्स रेडिकल राइट. सो दिस अवर अल्काइल हैलाइड फाइनली विल. ओके नाउ सी व्हाट हैपन. So write this one. So from here, section here, right, beta. So let's write this one. X, CS2, CS3, plus X radical, right? So this is the first reaction, beta. This is second, right? So see, beta, it was observed that the reaction with HF, right? This was beta. This step was exothermic. Means so you can say if this step is exothermic, so its delta H value will be beta negative, right? And its second step beta was found to be endothermic. So its value will be, if it is endo, so positive, right? In the case of chlorine, again it is exo, value is negative, again it is endo, value is positive, right? And beta with Br na, it was found that both the steps of this reaction found to be exothermic, right? Means the both the steps are exothermic, that is negative negative. And where in case of beta iodine, the first step was endo, that is positive value, and the second was exo, that is negative. So this is the experimental data, right beta. It was found that the first reaction with HI, with the your alkene, right beta, with fluorine beta, it was exothermic, and the second step was endothermic, right? First is exo, second is endo. Same with chlorine, it was found that the first step was exo and the second was endo. So beta, see, if you take HF or HCl now, so the this first step will take place obviously, right? But when you come on to the second step beta, so this reaction you can say this step will not take place. So the final product will not form. Why? Because this reaction, you can say this step is endothermic, so you have to provide some energy if you want to proceed this reaction. Okay, so with HF this reaction will not possible because the second step is endothermic in nature, right? But in case of bromine beta, see, both these steps are exothermic. Both these steps are beta exothermic in nature. In case of bromine, this is the first step which was exothermic, and this was the second step again which was exothermic. So in this case, you can say anti-Markovnikov rule takes place, right? Now come on to the last, bromine. So beta, with bromine na, फर्स्ट टैप वॉज फाउंड टू बी एंडो. सो इन दिस केस बेटा द फर्स्ट रिएक्शन विल नॉट टेक प्लेस. मीन्स यू कैन सी हियर दिस एक्स रेडिकल कैन नॉट रिएक्ट विद दिस एल्कीन टू फॉर्म दिस रेडिकल, राइट. सो दिस इज द रीजन सो दैट मार्कोव ने कहा बेटा ओनली ऑब्जर्व विद HBR. व्हाई? बिकॉज़ इन दिस रिएक्शन बट इन द मैकेनिज्म बोथ दी स्टेप्स आर एक्सोथर्मिक इन नेचर इन केस ऑफ HBR. वेयर एज विद HF और HCl बेटा द फर्स्ट स्टेप वाज एक्सोथर्मिक, इट इज फाइन, बट द एंड द सेकंड स्टेप वाज एंडोथर्मिक. द सेकंड स्टेप विल नॉट टेक प्लेस, सो द फाइनल प्रोडक्ट विल नॉट फॉर्म. एंड वेयर एज इन द केस ऑफ HI द फर्स्ट स्टेप विल नॉट, राइट. सो फर्दर रिएक्शन विल नॉट टेक प्लेस. So you can also understand this ki why anti-Markovnikov rule beta or your crash effect or your peroxide effect, right, will takes place only with HBr. Okay, so this is all about Markovnikov and anti-Markovnikov rule, right. Now beta, there is only one thing is remaining that is very important, right. Means the reactions beta that involving rearrangements, right. So you can also have another topic, rearrangement reactions, right. So see beta, what kind of rearrangement reaction are taking place. So beta, these rearrangement reaction beta may be 1-2 hydride shift depending on the structure of the molecule, right. It may be 1-2 hydride shift or it may be 1-2 methyl shift. What does it mean? I will tell you. Right, either it may be 1-2 hydride shift or either it may be 1-2 methyl shift, right. You see beta, whenever a less stable carbocation form, right, whenever a less stable carbocation will form na beta, you can say it will become stable by rearrangement reaction, right, via 1-2 methyl shift beta or 1-2 hydride shift, right. Means beta, whenever a less stable carbocation is formed, right. So it can beta become stable after rearranging itself, right, via 1-2 methyl shift or via 1-2 hydride shift. Okay, see, so we know the stability order of carbocation. Do you know beta? Right? Means tertiary carbocation are more stable as compared to secondary, and secondary are more stable as compared to the primary, right? And primary are more stable as compared to, you can say simply CH3 plus radical. Okay? This is the order of stability of carbocation, right? See beta, what happened? If I just write CH3 CH2, CH2 कार्बोकैटायन। सो वी नो बेटा दिस इज प्राइमरी कार्बोकैटायन, राइट, बिकॉज दिस कार्बन इज अटैच ओनली विद डायरेक्टली वन कार्बन है, सो दिस इज प्राइमरी कार्बोकैटायन, राइट। सो बेटा सी देयर इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी, सो दैट आई कैन, आई एम जस्ट राइटिंग दिस H2 इन दिस वे CH एंड अनदर हाइड्रोजन बेटा आई एम जस्ट रिप्रेजेंटिंग दिस, ओके, दिस अनदर दिस वन, ओके। नाउ बेटा सी देयर इज अ टेंडेंसी सो दैट दिस हाइड्रोजन ना विल रिमूव फ्रॉम दिस कार्बन एटम एज अ हाइड्राइड, राइट। मीन्स वॉट इज हाइड्राइड बेटा, हाइड्राइड इज हाइड्रोजन हैविंग टू इलेक्ट्रॉन्स और यू कैन से शेयर्ड पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन, राइट। मीन्स दिस हाइड्राइड, राइट बेटा, विल रिमूव, दिस हाइड्रोजन विल रिमूव एज हाइड्राइड मीन्स कंटेनिंग टू इलेक्ट्रॉन। तो सी बेटा इन दिस बॉन्ड ना देयर आर टू इलेक्ट्रॉन, दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन इज ऑफ कार्बन व्हाइट वन एंड दिस ब्लैक वन बेटा इज ऑफ हाइड्रोजन बिकॉज इट्स अ कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड, राइट। सो दिस हाइड्रोजन बेटा विल रिमूव एज हाइड्राइड मीन्स बोथ द इलेक्ट्रॉन विल कम विद हाइड्रोजन, ओके। इफ बोथ द इलेक्ट्रॉन विल कम विद हाइड्रोजन बेटा सो इट विल रिमूव एज एच माइनस एंड देयर विल बी टू इलेक्ट्रॉन, ओके। सो व्हेन इट विल गेट अटैच टू दिस सी एच टू ग्रुप, सो वी कैन से दिस वन इज वन टू अंडरगो वन टू हाइड्राइड शिफ्ट एंड वाई इट इज वन टू, सी बेटा I'm just writing this carbon is one, right, and this carbon is two. So that's why you can say this is 1-2 hydride shift, right? Or you just can say just write this two or this one, right? So see. This will convert into CH3. CH, now this will get a positive charge, this will convert into CH3. So now see beta, this primary radical now it has been converted into secondary carbocation, sorry radical nahi, carbocation, right. So this primary carbocation beta after rearranging means by 1-2 hydride shift is converting into secondary radical carbocation. So we know secondary carbocation are more stable, so if there is a possibility to rearrange, so obviously had 1-2 hydride shift or 1-2 methyl shift will take place, right, and a less stable carbocation will convert into a more stable carbocation, okay. So in this case I can say primary carbocation is converting into beta secondary carbocation, right. Primary is converting into secondary by 1-2 hydride shift, 1-2 hydride shift, right. So there is a possibility beta whenever a less stable carbocation is formed, so it may undergo 1-2 hydride shift and become more stable, okay. So this was a one example. Now see another example beta, if I just write CH3, CH, CH3, CH2 carbocation. Again, there is beta a tendency. See now beta, there are two possibilities, right? So this is carbon atom, right? Containing positive charge. So in this case, I can say beta, this is again primary radical, sorry, carbocation, right? Primary carbocation. So see beta, they are, you can say one methyl group that is attached to 1-2 position, right? If I just a number, right? So this is one and this is two. So beta, on this carbon atom na, there is one methyl group and another is hydrogen. So see, I can also write this hydrogen in this way, just remove from here and just represent in this way. So this is second carbon, right beta? So there are two possibilities now. Means this methyl group can also undergo 1-2 methyl shift and this one hydride shift. So I can write 1-2 हाइड्राइड शिफ्ट, राइट? एंड द सेकेंड केस, जस्ट रिमूव दिस वन फ्रॉम हियर, सेकेंड केस बेटा, वन टू मिथाइल शिफ्ट. ओके, टू सी, टू सी बेटा, इफ इट विल, इट मे अंडरगो बेटा वन टू हाइड्राइड शिफ्ट, व्हाट विल हैपन इन दिस केस? This will remove as hydride, so both the electrons will come with hydrogen and will attach to this group, right? And it will convert into CH3. This will become CH3 and now convert into carbon, right, beta? So after, see, this is primary carbon, right? After undergo beta 1-2 hydride shift, primary कार्बोकैटायन इज कन्वर्टिंग इनटू टर्शियरी कार्बोकैटायन आफ्टर 1-2 हाइड्राइड शिफ्ट, राइट? मींस बिफोर द हाइड्राइड शिफ्ट बेटा दिस वाज प्राइमरी एंड आफ्टर द हाइड्राइड शिफ्ट विल बिकम टर्शियरी कार्बोकैटायन, राइट? नाउ सी इन द सेकंड केस, इफ इट विल अंडरगो 1-2 मिथाइल शिफ्ट, राइट? सो इन दिस केस व्हाट विल हैपन इन दिस केस बेटा, दिस इज द सेकंड केस, दिस मिथाइल ग्रुप विल रिमूव एज CH3 minus and it will contain both these electrons, right? Means of this carbon and itself. So it will break from here, it will remove from here, right beta, as a CH3 minus, right? So it will form CH3. So I can write simply CH, this one, it will get a positive charge, this will become CH2 and there is one CH3 group that is attached. So beta, see, now it will convert into, this is secondary, you can say this carbon is attached to two carbon atoms, right? So this is secondary carbocation, this is tertiary carbocation, right? So if beta it undergo 1-2 hydride shift, so in this case beta a tertiary carbocation is forming, and if it undergo 1-2 methyl shift, then in that case beta secondary carbocation is forming. So obviously it will not undergo 1-2 methyl shift, it will undergo 1-2 hydride shift. Why? Because after undergo 1-2 hydride shift na, the primary carbocation is converting into tertiary carbocation. Okay, via 1-2 hydride shift. Okay, so this will be the intermediate, final tertiary carbocation will form. Okay, now see, there is another possibility beta. If I just write CH3 CH2 positive charge, right? So we know beta, again this is primary red carbocation. Why it is primary? Because it is now directly attached with one carbon atom, right? So again it is primary. So again beta, in this case, see, if it is one, just give it number one, right? This is carbon one, this is two, right beta? So there are two methyl group, there is no hydrogen atom, right? So obviously in this case it will undergo 1-2 methyl shift, right? Why? Because in this case beta there are two methyl groups, so obviously any one of them will participate in 1-2 methyl shift. There is no hydrogen atom, right? So in this case beta, again this methyl group will remove from here and it will undergo 1-2 methyl shift, and what will be the product? CH3, this will become positive charge, CH2, it will get a CH3 group, and here CH3 group, right? So again in this case, why beta? By undergo 1-2 methyl shift, primary carbocation is converting into, again it is tertiary carbocation. Okay, so in this case beta, we can say again it will undergo, whenever this carbocation will form, so it will undergo 1-2 methyl shift. Okay, getting my point? And this is methyl shift, in which this CH3 minus, you can say zinc. Okay, now see the question. सी दिस इज द क्वेश्चन बेटा, CS3 CH3 CH double bond and I'm just adding HBr, right? So what will be the reaction in this product in this case, right? You have to just write down the major product. Right. So beta, if you will not consider na, is there is an possibility to of rearrangement reaction. So you will write just by using the Markovnikov rule. Means just add this Br minus to that carbon atom that has lesser number of hydrogen atom. Means you just attach this bromine to this carbon atom, right? So this will be your product. So you just write this one CH2. Just write CH3. Right, beta. So you just write this one according to Markovnikov. But this product will not form, right? Why? What happened in this case? You see, this alkene beta will attach to this H plus ion, this will dissociate into H plus and Br minus ion, right? So this alkene will attach to this H plus ion, right? And when this attach this H plus ion beta, so according to Markovnikov rule, this will attach to this carbon atom that has lesser number of hydrogen atom. So CH3 CH CH3 CH, right beta? This will happen, right? Means this H plus ion is attached to that carbon atom that has lesser number of hydrogen atom, right? So it may attach with this CH, right? So but after that beta, it may rearrange with this carbon atom. Okay, so we can say now this will become CH3. Right? When this H plus ion attaches this CH beta, so this H will attach this CH, so this will become CH plus and this will become CH3, right? Now what will happen? Again, there is a tendency beta of 1, 2. See, I can also write this one. This H in this way, right? So again, this hydrogen beta undergo 1, 2 hydride shift. So you can write simply this is 1 and this is 2. This one, so it will convert into CH3 carbon and it will get beta positive charge. CH3 CH and this will become HCH2 and CH, right? So instead of beta, you can say according to Markovnikov rule, it will attach to this carbon atom, but instead of this, it will attach to this. Why? Because there is a tendency to rearrange, right? To rearrange this, you can say carbocation via 1-2 hydride shift. So in this case, you can say beta, it will not attach to that carbon atom that has lesser number of hydrogen atom, right? Why? Because there is a beta possibility so that it may can easily rearrange itself, right, and convert into from less stable carbocation, right, to more stable carbon. Getting my point? Means if you will just add this H plus ion beta to this, so primary carbocation will form. Okay, but when you attach this one beta, so there is a tendency so that this H plus ion, this one can rearrange and it will convert into more stable carbon. So in this, due to this reason beta, this H plus ion, right, this one attached to this CH2 group and it will become carbocation, then there will be possibility of 1-2 hydride shift, right, and it will form this carbocation. Now beta, finally the Br minus, this Br minus ion, right beta, attack this cargo cation and it will convert into CH3, this Br, CH2, CH3. Means beta, instead of this, you can also write the name of this compound, है ना? So you can also write the name will be C. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. If you write from left hand side and if you write from right hand side, 1, 2, 3, 4. So both are same, right? So that's why I'm just starting from this 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So this will become 2-bromo, right, beta? 3-methyl butane. 2-bromo-3-methyl-butane. This will be the IUPAC name, right? So instead of beta, this what will be our product formed as major product? So in this way, 1, 2, 3, 4. So the major product will be formed beta 2-bromo-2-methyl-butane, right? Means instead of 2-bromo-3-methyl-butane beta, 2-bromo-2-methyl-butane will be formed, right? So it will not undergo Markovnikov addition. Why? Because there is possibility to rearrange, right? Via 1-2 hydride shift. So always remember beta at this point, whenever you have to just practice this kind of question, is there any possibility or not, right? So that after forming a carbocation, it will become more stable or not, right? So you have to check. Now see one more example. Right, again, so in this case beta, again a carbocation again will form, right? So again beta, so we'll attack to this CH3 CH3 CH. So again beta, carbocation will form to this carbon atom, right? And this will become CH3. Why? Because beta, you can see very clearly after formation of this carbocation, there is again possibility, so that it may undergo here 1-2, in this case, very good, 1-2 methyl shift, right? Means CH3 minus will remove and it will convert into CH3 positive cation will form here. This will become CH and there is one CH3 group and another CH3 group. Now finally beta, the Br minus ion, which is bromide ion, will attack to this carbocation and it will convert into CH3 CCH3 and here Br, right? CH3 and CH3. Okay, so this will be the final product that will form in this reaction. The major product, right? So because there is a tendency of again 1-2 methyl shift, right? So this carbocation will form, again it will undergo 1-2 methyl shift. And finally, this product will form. Okay, so beta, this is all about rearrangement reaction. So always just keep in mind this concept beta. Whenever, right, an alkene reacts with an halogen acid, right, and after formation of carbocation beta, is there any tendency or not of rearrangement? If there is any tendency of rearrangement, right, whether it may be forming less stable carbocation, so just form that less stable carbocation. Why? Because after undergoing 1-2 hydride or 1-2 methyl shift beta, it will become more stable. Okay, so if you will form pair, this will form become tertiary secondary carbocation, and this tertiary secondary carbocation beta in this case becoming more stable. That is from secondary to, in this case, tertiary carbocation, and in this case beta again is converting from secondary to tertiary carbocation. Okay. So this is via 1,2-methyl shift. Okay. So this will be our major product. So beta, I hope you like this video. If you like this, so please like and subscribe our channel. We'll make more videos on this topic. So thank you for watching. And take care. Bye.